to show you how to create a list of all the comments that you have on your worksheet. I have a sheet that's fairly long here, full of data, and I have comment there, and further down I have another comment, and I know there's several comments, and I know that if I just look for the little red triangles, I'm going to probably miss them. I found a macro that will allow you to display all the comments from your sheet on a separate sheet. And so I'm going to run this macro. So I go to macros. I go list comments here, and I go run. And there I have a second sheet, and I have the location of the comment, who it was made by, and they're all made by me, but if anybody else was on the sheet, it would be their name. And then I have the actual comment written here. So I will show you the code. First of all, what we did is we defined a few variables, which is the comment, integer is I, worksheet is worksheet, WS is worksheet, commission sheet as the worksheet with your comments on it, set comments to active sheet. And then, so now the first thing you say is that if there's no comments on the sheet, then exit sub, which is fine. What you do is for each worksheet in worksheets, if worksheet name equals comment, then I equals one. What we're doing is renaming the first sheet after the active sheet to comments. And then for each list comment in comment sheet, we're setting up the headers here for the comments sheet. And so we have comments in, comments by, comments, and the actual comment here. And then we set the font to bold, interior colors, and then you set it up as normal, and the column width equals 20. The next thing we do is that we go for range worksheet, range A2. If that's blank, then you fill in the address, the person who said it, and the one in the actual comment. Or else, then you go to the, if that one's already full, then you go to, here it's XL down, offset equals 1. So you go to the bottom line, and then you place the comment, the comment location, the person who said it, and the actual comment. And then you end if, and then you continue the loop. Now, I will include this in the comments of my video, so you can copy it right off of there. Please subscribe.